Welcome to the SFCC Library video tutorial on how to use NoodleTools Express. NoodleTools Express is a free citation generator that can help you with creating MLA, APA, or Chicago citations. I like NoodleTools Express because it offers many different citation formulas with no advertising. To begin with, go to my.noodletools.com/noodlebib/express. The first thing you need to do is choose your citation format. I'm going to use MLA for our example. Once again, it's going to ask me a second time for what citation style I want to use, and I'm going to choose MLA. Then you need to choose from this long list of options what type of source you are citing. The commonly cited items are at the top, but there are many, many options, so I encourage you to scroll through to see what they are. For our example, I'm going to say that we are citing this video that's available on YouTube called Caffeine 101. So I'm going to go back to that list, and while many people would probably want to cite this as a website, I'm going to continue scrolling down, and I'm going to see that there is an option for a video clip online. Then I'm going to choose Create Citation. And notice here it says, well, is that video clip from a website or is it from a database? Now ours is from YouTube, so that's a website. So I'm going to keep that highlighted in blue. Please note that if you think you may have chosen the wrong item, you still have some options to change your selection right here. Another thing in NoodleTools Express is they give you the guide, which will actually give you the citation formula. So if you click on the plus sign, here is what the formula looks like if you just wanted to write it out without using the generator. But we're going to use the generator. So first, I'm going to just grab the URL. The date that it was published, which is listed right here, November 9th, 2018. So November 9th, 2018. And the day that we looked at it for us, or the day that accessed, I'm going to click here. Then the title of the video clip, which is Caffeine 101. And remember, generators are only as good as the information you put into it. So if you misspell something, you will have a misspelling in your citation at the end. If you're not sure, you'll see this little I button will pop up, and that'll give you some more information related to that box. Notice it even says here, is this on a site like YouTube? Yes, ours is from YouTube. So that's the name of the site. Then it says here the contributors. So who posted this article? And in this instance, it is posted by National Geographic. Now, National Geographic isn't the first name. You'll notice here it says last name or group. So this is a group. Geographic. And then if I had a second contributor, I could click on Add Contributor. Then I click Save, and you'll see here they have put it into the correct format for me. I would copy and paste that into my Word document or wherever I'm keeping my citations. Please note they give you some examples underneath of things that might happen when you copy and paste your citation, for example, formatting changes, etc. It also will help you with your in-text citation. So let's say you are referring to this video in an essay that you're writing. When you click on parenthetical citation, they'll say this is what it should look like. It's going to say Caffeine 101, and then you should input the exact time that you are referencing. And it has some other examples down here for how to do in-text citations. So just some reminders that citation generators are only as good as the information that you input. So make sure that you've spelled things correctly, that you haven't forgotten to fill in some sort of information, and also check your formatting when you copy and paste the citation at the end, because it will lose things like italics or indentations, etc. Thank you for watching this tutorial on NoodleTools Express. If you have any questions about citations, please contact the library, Or you can also check out our citation guide at libguides.spokanefalls.edu/cite.